is our great country. The land we live in. The land we're so proud of. Our own United States of America. It's a big country, this land of ours. A country of broad plains and rolling prairies, of vast forests and fertile fields, rivers and lakes, high mountains, little villages, and great cities. No wonder we're so proud of America. There's so much to be proud of. And here's one of the most wonderful things about this vast country of ours. No matter where we want to travel, no matter how far raw materials and finished products must be transported, there are trains. Beautiful, comfortable passenger trains for people to travel on. And long, sturdy freight trains to carry all kinds of raw materials and manufactured goods. Have you ever stopped to think how really important railroads are? Have you ever thought of what it takes for the millions of people in this great country to be able to travel from one end of the land to the other with speed, safety, comfort, and at low cost? Have you ever marveled at the iron ore and coal and hundreds of other raw materials that move continuously to the nation's widespread factories? And how thousands of different finished products are delivered from where they are made to where they are needed in all parts of the country? Have you ever wondered how the foods we eat are always being delivered from the farms to our markets, and how they arrive fresh as the day they were picked? Well, the answers to those questions make up one of the most fascinating and important stories in the history of our country. The story of the American railroads. In order to tell you that story, we're going to visit the railroad yards. We're going into the railroad stations and out along the tracks. In that way, you will get a better idea of what the nation's railroad system is like and the big, important job trains are always doing. Then, the next time you are on a train, or the next time you see a train speeding off into the distance, you'll understand how much we all depend on railroads and how much they do to help make and keep this land of ours the most wonderful and prosperous nation in the world. When our country was young and much smaller than it is today, traveling was slow, uncomfortable, and dangerous, and so people didn't travel very much. Then, just a little more than 100 years ago, came the one thing the young country needed to grow into an important nation: adequate transportation. That transportation came in the form of railroads. Those early trains were funny little affairs when compared with the big trains we see rolling today. But they had a lot to do with opening up and developing vast new territories, which later became states. You could say that America and her railroads grew up together. As the railroads pushed ahead, settlers followed. Farms were cleared and crops planted. Mines were opened and the railroads began moving the ore and the coal to mills and factories. Villages which sprang up around the railroad stations grew and prospered into big, important cities. Throughout the length and breadth of the land, trains come and go, day and night, in all kinds of weather, carrying millions of people and millions of tons of freight. Because we don't always see the trains which serve us, maybe everyone doesn't realize how essential railroads are to our everyday living. But somewhere on its journey from raw materials to finished products, nearly everything we eat, wear, or use moves by train. And only railroads have the capacity to carry at low cost and over long distances the enormous volume of goods it takes to keep this nation going. Trains carry people too. And as everyone likes to travel, suppose we see what happens when we take a train trip. We'll go along with these two friends of ours, Carol and Jimmy. That is, if Jimmy can ever get Carol's suitcase shut. In real life, their parents would probably go along with them. But for this picture, suppose we let Carol and Jimmy travel by themselves, okay? There they go in the taxi cab that will take them to the railroad station. Almost every town has a railroad station. Some are larger than others, but all railroad stations, large or small, are very interesting places. For example, at most railroad stations, you will usually find the railway express. You will see people checking and sorting packages to make certain that they will be put aboard trains which will take them to their destinations without delay. And remember, they will handle almost anything, including your dog. In the yards of many railroad stations, cars are cleaned inside and out to put them into tip-top condition for the passengers who will soon be getting aboard. In another part of the yards, dining cars are stocked with fresh vegetables, meats, milk, and all the other foods that will be needed for the meals that will be served when the train is on its way. Nearby, there is usually an engine house where locomotives are brought for cleaning and servicing. Maybe you've wondered how great big locomotives are turned around. Well, let's watch and see how easy it is. The locomotive is run onto the turntable. On goes the power, and around goes the locomotive as easy as you please. Say, we'd better not forget Carol and Jimmy. Here they are, arriving in plenty of time to check their baggage and buy their tickets before their train is scheduled to leave. Pay the taxi driver, Jimmy, and get a check from the red cap for each one of your handbags. The next stop is to buy tickets. Now let's see, Jimmy and Carol are going to visit their aunt and uncle at a town about 1,000 miles away. They will be coming back by train, so they will buy round-trip tickets. Buying round-trip tickets, they will be saving money, too. The ticket clerk stamps each ticket with the date on which the ticket is purchased and the date on which the ticket is used. So far, so good. As Carol and Jimmy are going to sleep on the train, they'll have to have sleeping car tickets, too. That's right. You're all set now. Say, you'd better not take too much time paying for your tickets, Jimmy, because here comes your train. There's nothing quite as exciting as a railroad station at train time. From the time the train arrives until it is ready to leave again is usually only a matter of a very few minutes. But during that short period, many things happen. Trunks, luggage car near the head end of the train. The United States mail is put aboard the railway mail car. Cleaned by a mechanical washer. Friends and relatives bid each other last minute goodbyes. Passengers like Carol and Jimmy board their cars and are shown their space in the car by the porter. It's just about time now for the train to pull out.